Are you thinking about quitting your job, packing your bags, and moving to Hawaii? If you are, make sure you watch this video because I'm gonna tell you what not to do before moving to Hawaii. Aloha y'all, my name is Stacy Johnson. I'm a real estate investor here in Honolulu, Hawaii. And on this channel, we talk about all things Hawaii real estate, lifestyle, money, and side hustles. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more videos dropping every Tuesday and Friday at 1 p.m. Hawaii Standard Time. If you haven't already, make sure you follow me on all my social media channels at the link in the description below. Now let's get right into it. Don't do this when moving to Hawaii. I'm gonna give you 10 things that you should not do when you are moving to Hawaii. Number one is quit your job. Do not quit your job before coming to Hawaii because some people think that you can just quit your job greeting at Walmart in Indiana and come here and think you can do the same thing. There is a huge amount of people here and not that many jobs. This job market can be very competitive to break into, and if you don't have any really valuable skills, it might be really difficult for you to find a job. Number two, do not stop in the middle of the road to take pictures. I know everything is beautiful. I know there's beautiful views on the mountainside plus beautiful views on the ocean side, but do not stop in the middle of the road. This will piss off the locals and you'll get a ton of people sticking middle finger, beeping their horn, whatever, the whole nine yards.
Go home, you loser!
Traffic is already hard in itself. You don't want to be an adder to that problem. In the winter, the North Shore of Oahu can sometimes get waves up to 100 feet. And there's a lot of tourists that will stop in the middle of the road just to take a photo. Don't be that guy. Number three, do not touch or get close to wildlife. I know. You really want to take a selfie with a dolphin. You really want to take a selfie with a honu or slash sea turtle. Just don't.
Don't you do it!
These are endangered animals. They are protected animals. Do not touch the animals. These are wild animals and you just never know what they're going to do. Might as well go touch a shark then. And this includes coral. Do not be stepping on coral. Coral is a living and breathing organism. Every time you step on coral, you are destroying Hawaii's natural habitat and you're not allowing other people to enjoy what you're trying to enjoy right now. Don't step on coral. Number four is do not park in front of your neighbor's house. It's not actually a legally bound thing that you can call the cops for, but it's an unspoken rule that you get the parking in front of your house. There are a lot of people in Hawaii and there's not a lot of houses, plus houses are really expensive. So a lot of people live in multi-generational units. What that means is that they live with a ton of their family in one house so that they can afford it. This also means that there's a lot of cars. Typically they need that space in front of their house to park. Number five is do not take lava rocks home. The United States Postal Service in Hawaii actually gets a ton of rocks shipped in the mail. It is really bad luck to disturb the peace of the earth here in Hawaii. It's very sacred. There are stories of people who have taken lava rocks or coral back to their home in Indiana or whatever on the mainland, and they start experiencing extremely bad luck that just came out of nowhere after they came home from Hawaii. And because of this, they end up shipping this lava rock or this coral back to Hawaii because they don't want to deal with the superstitions. Even though somebody told them not to take the rock, they took it anyway and they wanted to test their luck, and now they're super scared. So don't be that guy who takes lava rock.
You have been warned.
You should not be touching any of the earth and moving it around to make it beautiful. An example of this is when people stack rocks. There's no need to stack rocks. That's very unnatural. Let the rocks fall where they may fall. Number six is not saying thank you when you cut somebody off. So make sure you're saying thank you when you go into somebody else's lane when you're driving. It is a common courtesy here. You just throw up the shaka, throw up the hand, just say thank you. Many people will let you in, but make sure you're saying thank you, because typically in the mainland when I used to drive, nobody would ever let you in. Nobody would let you take a left turn. In Hawaii, that's just standard. You just let people drive. And if somebody's taking a left turn and there's a long line behind, it's not unnatural to see somebody stop and let that person take a left turn. Just make sure you say thank you.
Thank you very much.
Number seven is do not call all locals Hawaiian. Hawaiian is an ethnicity that is native to the island of Hawaii. Not everybody who lives here and is born here is Hawaiian.
Fact.
Me personally, yes, I am born and raised in Hawaii, but I am Filipino. My parents are from the Philippines.
Filipino, Filipino, Filipino.
The people who have ancestry dating back here in Hawaii, those are the Hawaiians, and you can call them Hawaiians, but not all locals are Hawaiians. Number 8 is do not ignore the no trespassing signs, especially when it comes to hikes. So there's a lot of hikes in Hawaii where a lot of tourists will ignore the signs not to cross a cliff or something, and they end up dying. Super morbid, but it's honestly the facts, because I remember growing up, we used to jump off this one cliff, do a lot of cliff jumping into the water, into the ocean. You know, we know the ocean, we've done it many times before, we've seen our adult friends do it. We grew up doing this. A tourist will go there and try to jump off thinking that they know what they're doing, and all of a sudden they're dead and on the news. This has happened more times than once. The government then ends up putting signs that say, hey, no crossing here, don't go past this sign, and yet you still see a lot of tourists go past the sign.
You're a bit of a bastard, aren't you?
And so if you are moving to Hawaii and you see these signs, make sure you follow them. Do not think that you can do all these things that like people grew up doing because they live on an island. It's just not the case.
That's called common sense. That in your tiny mind is not common.
Number 9 is do not wear shoes or slippers inside the house. You always, always, always take your shoes off before coming inside the house. It's very much like Asian culture. People will look at you like you're weird and dirty and gross. Take your damn shoes off. And the last one, I would say this is the most important, because everyone thinks that living in paradise, there's no crime here. But number 10, do not leave valuables exposed in the car. People think that, oh, this is paradise, nobody steals here, so beautiful, the people are beautiful, they don't steal. There are people who wait in parking lots, by the hotels, in tourist heavily spots, waiting to see you put stuff in your trunk, expose stuff, and leave the window down. Even if you don't leave the window down, but you have no tinted windows, you leave valuables exposed, they will be gone, they will be stolen. Just because we live in paradise, it doesn't mean that there's no crime here. Well, thanks for watching that video. That was a totally different take on what I usually post as far as content. If you like this kind of content, make sure you let me know in the comments below, and I'll put out more content about Hawaii or anything Hawaii. If you guys have a specific question you want to ask that I can talk about, go ahead and let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Aloha, and see ya on the next video.